Back live on Monday Night Raw Super Show, John Morrison set the team with Alex Riley in this tag team matchup tonight against the very fragile tag team of United States Champion Dolph Ziggler and Jack Swagger. And you see Vicky Guerrero, who is the, business associate of Dolph Ziggler.
Well, Vicky Guerrero has been quite a quandary, if you ask me. She is trying to put both Dolph Ziggler and Jack Swagger on the same page, and you know, I'll give Vicky Guerrero props. I mean, she's a good manager, but I don't even know if Vicky Guerrero can get these two guys together.
Well, it was Vicky Guerrero who actually set up this matchup here tonight, her request to try to get Ziggler and Swagger JR working together.
And Ziggler, the United States champion, taking down on John Morrison. I think it would be a great move for Swagger to associate with Vicky Guerrero, quite frankly, at this point in his career.
Yeah, but Dolph doesn't seem to want anything to do with that relationship.
Yeah, look at this move.
Well, Lawler, you know, if you continue to want to compete here on Monday Night Raw, you might as well hire Vicky to be your manager.
Ooh! What, because we got a match tonight against Otunga and McGillicuddy?
Oh! Oh, what a kick. You going to give us any idea who your team is?
Kick in the cover by Morrison.
I'm not gonna tell you who my partner is going to be. That's going to be a surprise. But Otunga and McGillicuddy, they should talk to Vicky Guerrero. At least she's got some charisma.
Ooh! Vicky Guerrero has managed champions in her career, and I believe as well she should expand her clientele. But to your point earlier, this project between Dolph and Swagger may be bigger than she can handle.
Well, it's obvious that Dolph Ziggler is so full of himself that he thinks there's not room for anyone except him in Vicky's stable.
There's the hook of the leg by Dolph Ziggler. You know, managers back in the day, Freddie Blassie, Lou Albano, always managed more than one person. They had stables. They had multiple individuals. Covered by the United States champion, Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah, but if you remember, JR, I don't think those superstars that were in the... Jeez, just not on the same page.
Well, Swagger wants to tag in, and Ziggler said no way. Ooh, and maybe Dolph should have made a tag.
I don't think there was jealousy between those superstars. Like, Captain Lou's, Lou Albano's superstars always seemed to get along. They always had Captain Lou's back, he had theirs.
Yeah, Swagger made a tag himself, got himself in, as did Alex Riley. Riley.
A-Rod has been on a tear as of late.
Nice spine buster by Alex Riley.
Look at Riley go.
Big athletic young man from Boston College.
Look at Dolph go up to the floor.
Oh, man!
That could be it!
Riley looking.
How did Swagger kick out of that?
Well, you know, and JR and I both know, this Jack Swagger is one tough young man.
Absolutely.
Oh, there's Swagger.
Oh, watch that ankle lock!
Oh, what a torturous maneuver this ankle lock is, a submission maneuver.
And hey! Ooh!
And Dolph Ziggler in the wrong place at the wrong time there.
Well, A-Rod rolled right through there. Look at this move. This could be it. You got him.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it was in
match. The team of John Morrison and Alex Riley.
In my mind, it looked like Alex Riley tossed Swagger into Ziggler.
He's a loser. Me and you.
Ziggler screaming that Swagger's a loser.
Yeah, but yes, me. Watch, well. Still, my point is, watch this now. You will see Dolph Ziggler has a chance to help out his partner, but look at Dolph. He just watches his partner get pinned.
Again, it's pretty clear Dolph Ziggler wants nothing to do with his business relationship with Jack Swagger, and I think Swagger just saw the replay of what happened there.
And Ziggler not intervening cost Ziggler some money tonight, because they go home with a loser's share purse.
Well, Dolph Ziggler is claiming that Swagger lost it single-handedly.
I'm a real star. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome R-Truth and The Miz. Gentlemen, despite your recent claims that there's a conspiracy against both of you, Triple H has granted your request for a tag team championship match this Sunday against Air Boom. So with that said, have your feelings towards the COO changed?
Triple H does the obvious and grants us our rightful tag team championship match, and then everything is supposed to be okay. That's laughable. So is CM Punk, considering himself a martyr, the voice of the voiceless. All anyone is talking about is this face-off between Triple H and CM Punk. But oh wait, everybody, this time they're actually going to tell the truth. If Punk truly wanted to tell the truth, he'd change his name from CM to what it should be, BS.
You know what? I feel that Triple H has made a pretty good decision, man.
Really?
I respect
really?
It.
Really? Really?
Ninja, please. Hell no.
Wait, what did you just say?
I said, Ninja, waya, please. I want Triple H to lose this Sunday too. I want him out of here as COO. Come on, Miz, let's show these people the real truth.
I mean, you can't blame.
Truth is stranger than fiction.
Yeah, but what Miz and Truth are saying is correct. There is a conspiracy. If Triple H loses, he's out as COO. If he loses to Punk Sunday at Night of Champions.
It brings up a great question. If Triple H does lose, who will be the next COO?
Shut up. Triple H is COO. That spells cool. Now that two times spells cuckoo. Cuckoo is exactly what Triple H is if he think that we're going to let him off the hook. I hate to think the Miz and I should be in the main event of every WWE pay-per-view. And we going to prove that at the Night of Champions. And we going to prove that right now.
Because the truth is, this Sunday, Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston are going to get got.
And that is awesome!
Hey, the Miz is in action. The Awesome One takes on Kofi Kingston live next.